So now you have created your defense in depth. You have subscribed to your local law enforcement agency's social media sites and text notification services. You pay attention to news stories about crime in your community. You avoid distractions while driving and while you're with clients. And you're always looking for your escape routes no matter where you are. You have started demanding photo identification from prospects and checking the sex offender registry and social media sites for a more complete perspective on their history and character. Also, you have a personal and office policy of meeting the prospect at the office or in a public place to verify their identity and create a new client information form. You know who your designated backup agent is, and they have a copy of the client information form, your itinerary, and the time you are expected to return to the office. You have a good defense in depth with situational awareness, protective intelligence, and office safety. Now what? Your last layer of defense in depth is your personal safety toolbox. You must attend regular realtor safety and self-defense courses because personal safety is a perishable skill. Your car should be in good mechanical condition and never drive a client to a showing. Always park along the curb and never in a driveway where your vehicle can be blocked in. Think of your car as your escape capsule and be prepared to get off the X at the first sign of danger, return to your car, and leave to a safe area to call for help. While you are with clients, have any personal safety tools like pepper spray, flashlights, or stun guns concealed on your body, not buried in your purse. Be sure to practice with them so you can access and deploy the tools without looking. When you're conducting a showing or open house, never enter an area that doesn't have an exit like a garage, closet, or basement. Stay in doorways and always identify your primary and secondary escape routes, ready to leave at the first sign of danger. Have some pre-planned excuses to tell your client if you need to get off the X, and leave it to your intuition to sense trouble. Finally, your last option for survival when you can't escape and you are at risk of bodily harm is to incapacitate your assailant using your personal defensive weapons or techniques and escape to safety. This option is also a perishable skill and requires ongoing training through a reputable martial arts instructor. Keep yourself in good physical shape, both as a deterrent to predators and as a necessity to run or fight, and dress in a professional manner that enables you to run or defend yourself. The likelihood of being victimized while working as a realtor is low, but it does happen too often. Taking the threat seriously and implementing a defense-in-depth approach to personal safety empowers you to be more confident and productive in your personal and professional life, dissuades criminals intent on targeting realtors, and creates a culture of safety in an industry that desperately needs it. Be safe.